Before symptoms of multiple myeloma develop, Dana-Farber Cancer Institute researchers say a patient's risk of progression might be tied to certain precursor conditions. The findings were presented at the American Society of Hematology annual meeting. The research looked at the precursors monoclonal gammopathy of undetermined significance, or M-GUS, and smoldering multiple myeloma. Dana-Farber's Dr. Irene Gobriel says they sequenced the RNA in healthy cells and cells with these precursors and got interesting results.
When we went back to MGUS cells, which are the very early precursor cells, we could actually differentiate a normal plasma cell from a malignant plasma cell. And you can find those very early changes that happen at the gene level in those cells as they switch from benign to malignant, or as they switch from a normal to a cancer cell.
Dr. Gobriel says it's the first time they've looked at the microenvironment of these earliest stages. She says knowing the immune cells at these pre-malignant stages have already undergone a dramatic shift from healthy people will help shape future research.
And now the next step is trying to understand, are they truly critical for the progression, and can we target them? Can we develop therapy not only to kill the cancer cells, but to change that environment to make it a hostile environment so that the progression does not happen in early stages? And the hope is that you see a patient with MGUS, you give them something that potentially cures them, and we don't have myeloma anymore in the future.
Dr. Gobriel says she's encouraged by this early study and more research is needed. For Dana-Farber News, I'm Victoria Warren.